All right, welcome back. So, I've got a bunch of jugs over here, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna make some fireworks. Thing is, rather than explosions, I'm just gonna show you how to make the colors, but we're gonna do in solution. A little bit more contained, but just as exciting. So, what we're gonna start off with when it comes to these fireworks, rather than actually doing the explosion that they do up in the sky, we're actually gonna use ethanol to burn the metals that they use to create the colors. But I first want you to see what ethanol looks like before we actually start adding some colors to it. So what I got over here is ethanol and fire. So this is what it looks like on its own. Gives off a fair bit of heat. But when we put in this jug, I want you to see what color the ethanol looks like as it works its way through. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. All right, let's light this thing up. And we're gonna see what the color gives. Just ethanol on its own. All right, so that's ethanol. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the next one. We're gonna add a bit of metal to it and see what color that gives. All right, so for this one, we've got some nickel. Even though it's green in color as a solution, let's see what color it gives when it burns. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Let's light it up, see what color it gives. So when you see gold in fireworks, it's actually nickel that they're using. All right, so for the next one, we got this colorless solution, but it's strontium. So we're gonna put some strontium inside this jug, again using the ethanol as a way to sort of deliver it and to ignite it. And we're gonna see what color it gives when it burns. That should be enough. All right, let's see what happens. So when you see that deep, deep red in a firework, it's actually strontium that they've added to it. So for the last one, this blue color, we'll see what it gives. It's actually copper, but we'll see what color it gives. Now, to be honest with you, I gotta admit, this is one of my favorites. It gives the most intense color, the most exciting colors, and it's always fun to watch. So let's see what happens. Copper. So when you see that deep, deep nuclear green color in a firework, it's actually copper that you add. So hopefully you learned something new about this. You learned something new about fireworks and the metals that they use to actually give those really vibrant colors that you see up in the skies. All right, welcome back. So for the final demo, what we're gonna do is something called the traffic light reaction. It's a color reaction. All it is just liquids mixing back and forth, but there's something special about them. I got sugar water over here. So water and sugar, nothing exciting. And I got base, sodium hydroxide, a little bit like, you know, drain cleaner or something. And then in here, I've got a dye. It's indigo carmine. It's a blue dye, same color as your jeans. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix it together and it's gonna start a reaction. But the thing is, I'm gonna use this indicator to monitor that reaction. And as it consumes a bit of oxygen from the air and some of the sugar with the sodium hydroxide, it'll change color. It'll be really neat. So, I've already got the sugar water here. It's warmed up. We're gonna add a bit of dye. Indigo carmine. That's better. Now it's blue. Now we're gonna add a bit of base, about 80 mils. So now what we gotta do is just wait a minute for it to cycle through.
So you have the green, you've got the red, and it should go to a nice yellow. So now, this is also called an oscillating reaction, by the way, because it goes back and forth. So let's see what colors. Let's see if we can make it go to green. Yep, almost getting there. A little bit more. Just about complete. Almost like a chameleon. Now, I really want to push this fast. I'm a little bit impatient, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this in here. I'm going to do that. We're going to let a bit of oxygen in because it's consuming the oxygen. I'm going to cap that. Now watch what happens. Now as you can see, it's going from green to red and back to that really bright yellow that we have over here. And that's an oscillating reaction for you. That's chemistry, just with colors. So hopefully you enjoyed this and we'll see you soon.